Hello and welcome to the Slingshot channel. My magazine equipped arrow shooters have been getting very popular these days. No matter if it's this new toy that is handmade and not yet in the stores, that allows you to shoot quickly and effectively a lot of arrows, but also commercially available products like the extremely popular Steambow Stinger that you can get in my store actually. Having a magazine for 6 arrows can be cocked just with this lever here and even has a built-in laser tick so that it's accurate and really, really powerful. Bang! And the latest product that is shipping is the EK Archery Adder, something that I helped designing. Very cool to see my name on a commercial product. We just started to ship it. Just the first 2,200 pieces have arrived and we started to ship them. Second container is still some available. Second container is going to arrive in February 2020. Now this also, if you buy it from my store, has this laser light holder that I have actually designed that helps you aiming in the dark. And of course it comes with the red dot sight everything. And this is also a repeater, but it has a longer lever since the bow simply has more power. So, yeah, bang! That's a really a powerful crossbow. And you can repeat it quickly. Very powerful. So I invested so much time in exploring the idea of having a crossbow that is repeating and not single shot. The next step must be to make it full auto. I love my job. So how do you get it to shoot full auto? Well, it's not so easy because first we must select the power source. Obviously muscle energy is only good for repeating and not for full auto. Even if you would attach like a crank handle, it would still be a repeater, nothing else. Because what you need is something where you can pull the trigger and then it goes unless you release it. So muscle energy is not an option. Well, I can't do steam and I can't do like compressed air because my workshop just isn't prepared for things like this. But what I can do is drills. Modern battery drills are amazing products. I mean, look at how small they are, just only as long as my hand. And still they have like 100 Newton meters of torque. They have the entire gearbox set in, so you actually have two gears on a thing like this. Everything is just based in it. And in this battery, you got so much power, thanks to, I think, e-mobility. People have been investing so much money in battery power that this seems like the ideal source for a full auto thing. The only problem that we have is how do we get the rotational force into something that goes linear, cocking the crossbow and firing it back and forth. Well, there are several methods, but of course, quite obvious what you can do is you can use a crankshaft, just like in an engine. To explain the concept to you, I've made some models. As you know, I never steal somebody else's videos. Therefore, I'm not using any of the great videos that are available on it. But here's my model of a crankshaft device. As you see, there are rubber bands here. And it is our target to draw out these rubber bands because that could be the force of our bowstring. So there is a little crank here. And you see, this is like the piston in it. And if I turn it, you can see that I can well stretch out the rubber bands back and forth. So I'm converting rotational force into a horizontal force. Well, is that our solution? No, unfortunately it is not. Because look what happens when I add more rubber. So as you can see, this now creates a lot of friction. You can even see how the piston is canting when I go up and down. Like this edge is pushing upwards now. And the other edge is pushing downwards now. So this kind of friction eats a ton of energy. And we don't have any energy to lose because otherwise we would have to go down with the power of our draw force. Since energy that is lost in friction can't be used to cock back the bowstring. And this is because, of course, the piston wants to follow in the vector force, wants to follow the crank here. As you see, it wants to form like a straight line, and therefore it is pushing upwards against this edge here. So what we can do, since this is not a combustion engine that needs to be tied here, we can simply remove the guides here. So now we have moved this downwards, and as you can see now, when I move it up and down, what you can see is that the vector is now straight and this no longer has to bend. Actually, this entire joint is now no longer needed. And now there is no friction that eats up precious energy. Of course, you can see that this is no longer a straight line from the perspective of the system, but it doesn't matter because the rubber bands are still stretched out in full. In fact, we don't even need this part anymore. We can directly connect this to here, making the entire setup a lot shorter. So, as you see, now it's super, super short, but it still elongates the rubber bands the same way and it doesn't require any more force. Everything is a straight vector and nothing is wasted. I have, of course, not invented this principle. It was actually known for a long time, even in ancient China. So this is actually my personal reproduction of the Chinese Shukonu repeating crossbow, except that I converted it to shoot rubber and also use pencils like the IKEA pencils or other short pencils as ammo. And also enhanced it a little bit because I invented a spring magazine for it so that it doesn't really misfire anymore. You can simply load the pencils in here. And now what you can see is that it works the same way. What it does is it stretches this out, but as you see, the vector is completely straight. It's the same thing that happened on my little crankshaft and crank experiment, but it is just using rotational force, and at the end of it, it fires the arrow. And of course, you can repeat. So now, of course, we simply have to make this a full rotation so that I don't have to push it back anymore, but rotate it the whole way. So I have to get rid of this lower part and lift it all up so that I have space to rotate it. And of course, since I have a powerful drill, I don't need the lever. I will be turning this pivot point here directly. So that is the way to go. Well, can we make a setup like this? Sure. Let me show you what I came up with. Meet the Facil, the full auto sliding instant Legolas. Let me show you its features. So as you see, it is powered by this Makita drill. I've used that one before in a completely different design that was using like a rack and pinion method to convert rotational force into linear force. But the problem was also that there was a lot of friction. Therefore, I could not go very powerful. I had to use rubber bands because that wasn't powerful enough to use like an 80-pound pistol crossbow limb. So this now overcomes this by avoiding any friction. But also it means that it's shaking a lot because what the friction did is was smoothing out the motion, and now I have to compensate it with muscle power. And this means that I can no longer hold it like this and then operate the drill manually. So what I did is I put on this little lever system here that actually allows me to operate the drill remotely from this trigger. So I can hold it like this where the drill nicely sits in the crook of my arm, and when I fire, it actually allows me to control the speed by pressing hard or not so hard on this lever, like so. It's so much fun. What a hailstorm of arrows. A few details. First of all, what you can see here is that I had to use rollers for the rubber that presses down on the bolts in the magazine, simply because this holds 40 rounds. So the problem is that no spring would really stretch enough for this, would not be flexible enough. So therefore, by using the rollers here, I can do this with rubber and have an almost even force between the first and the last shot in the magazine. And this pin here is there because on the way backwards, the trigger here actually hits this and then is released when the hold setup is in the rearmost position. So let's go slowly. I can't stop going full power in the end. Now with you in full auto. Now I know what a lot of people are now gonna say. Make a replaceable magazines. Well, I've done this in the past for the earlier rubber-based shooter that I did, and it worked fairly well. I actually have one video, a tribute to Hickok 45, where I emptied 4 magazines against a metal target. It was a fun video. I could do it here, but of course it kind of limits the amount of rounds a little bit that you can put in here. It's mechanically very complicated, and this isn't really a weapon that I plan to use. It's more like a demonstration device to see that it is possible to do something like this with a drill. And also you're gonna say, well, this needs a counterbalance because it's vibrating and this is really bad. Well, of course it's vibrating, but it's not vibrating because this is out of balance. It is out of balance, but that doesn't really count because the real draw weight comes from this here. This is 80 pounds. So if I want to use a counterweight, I would have to use an 80 pound counterweight. And that would make it a little heavy, even for a strong guy like myself. So you have to live with a little bit of shake, but hey, that's half of the fun of shooting a full auto device. And actually, since you can aim with this like you aim with a garden hose, it's actually not so bad. Poor opponent. And even if I would use like a straightener here, just like the very first prototype that I showed you on one of my demo boards, the friction would be so intense that the thing would probably burst into flames. So actually it could be a good fire starter. Starting a fire with a drill. Maybe that's something I need to cover in a future video. Then you're gonna say, take the motor out of this here, attach it directly so it's not so bulky. Well, the problem is that there's also the gearbox in this here. This really requires all the space. There's no extra space in here. You need a little bit of space for the cooling as well. So therefore, I don't think that this was really making a big difference. And besides, I need my drill. I've been going to some length to actually make it possible to not change anything on the drill because I need it. By the way, before we finish, for the German people, I will hold a guest lecture at the Technical University of Chemnitz on the 16th of January, actually in a few days. And you can email me should you want to come. It happens starts in the morning and I can bring in a few guests. If you can't make it, it's not so bad because I will video record everything and put it online. So if you watch this video after the 16th, watch out for the link to the video that I'll be putting down there for you. Well, I hope you liked the Facil, the full auto sliding instant Legolas, because that's it for today. Thanks, Ed. Bye bye. Oh, a few more shots. My poor target. And see, we even had a Robin Hood hit here.